What's good with y'all boys, man? It's your boy Matt Godzilla, and today I'm here with y'all with my first ever high story time for y'all boys. And so basically, man, these are gonna be just me out here, you know what I'm saying, smoking a little something with y'all, just telling y'all funny, serious stories about my life. I will warn y'all, I'm gonna go ahead and put y'all on some game. These stories that I'm gonna tell y'all are 100% real. I don't make up none of this shit. I keep it beam with y'all. This is stuff that actually has happened to me in my life. So some of these stories are gonna be funny, some of these stories are gonna be wild, and some of these are gonna be very serious. Now this one today is gonna be very funny. Basically, man, this story time today is gonna be my worst ass whooping, bruh. And let me correlate that for y'all. I'm not talking about fighting. I'm talking about ass whooping, like, from my mom and shit, bro. Now, let me put y'all on to something real quick. Now, I'm gonna tell you something about my mom. I love my mom to death. We all know that. My mom was really like a cool ass mom, but she was a strict, like, my mom was a strict, cool mom, like, kind of mixed together. Like, she wasn't, like, super strict, like, wouldn't let me go nowhere. It was just a certain place she wanted me to go. But she was also a cool-ass mom. You know, she just let me have fun. Now, my mom was strict more with, like, school, like, keeping on my grades and shit. Kind of shit like that, right? But, yeah. Without further ado, man, let's get into the story time. Light that motherfucker up for y'all real quick. Fire this bitch up for y'all real quick. Mm-hmm. So basically, man, this story time takes place in, I think I was in the first grade. Yeah, I was in the first grade, right? And I used to have beef with this little Mexican nigga in my class, bro. Yeah, I used to have beef with this little Mexican nigga in my class. And basically, so one day, I'm gonna start with y'all like this. I was a badass little kid. I'm not even gonna hold y'all. Like, I was a badass little kid, bro. Like, I used to get in hella trouble when I was a kid. I used to get my ass beat all the fucking time as a kid, bro. So this was just like some normal shit, right? So, mind you, like, so me and this little Mexican dude in my class had beef or whatever, right? So, like, we had beef and shit. We used to always go at it, bro. And so one day, we in class, right? And we doing this little group assignment shit. And my teacher, she put me and him in a group together, right? That didn't fly with me. That nigga basically my op at this point. So, like, I don't even like that nigga. So, like, the fact that she even put us in a group together was... Shit was bound to go down, bro. And so basically, fucking... Me and that nigga was basically, it was me and him was arguing the whole time during the group project, right? But, basically me and this nigga was arguing the whole time during the shit, right? And, nigga, basically, he said some slick ass shit to me, right? And, I forgot what I said. I ain't gonna lie, it was low key kind of racist what I said, too. But I ain't really, it wasn't really racist, but the way he said, the way he told her, he like exaggerated like fuck, like over, he like, sorry, he over exaggerated that shit like crazy, like, so I think I called him a, Cheeto eating something. No, I called him a, I told him to shut up, you Cheeto eating fool. So, yeah, I called him a Cheeto-eating fool. Tell me why this motherfucker, this nigga gonna go up to her and tell her that I called him a Cheeto-eating bitch. Be fucking for real. He deadass told her I called him a Cheeto-eating bitch. be a Cheeto eating bitch, bro. Like, he dead ass told her that, bro. And then my first grade teacher, Miss Haynes, since I was one of her bad students, she believed this nigga. Like, she dead ass believed this nigga when he told her that, bro. Like, no cap. On me. So, like, he did, like, she dead ass believed that nigga too, like, on some whole shit, bro. Like, she dead ass believed that nigga, right? So, when he told her that, she had brought the whole group outside, right? Now, mind you, I'm obviously, this nigga is lying, like, fuck, yeah, I did call him a Cheeto eater, but he was capping about the bitch part, right? So, me, I'm thinking, okay, my group members, they gonna ride for me, like, they seen the argument, they obviously know I didn't call him no bitch, bro. Tell me why, when she bring us outside, both of them lie and said that I called him the bitch. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, yeah, like I thought y'all niggas supposed to have my back, and y'all niggas took this nigga's side? Bro, that shit pissed me off even more, bro. Like, that shit pissed me off even fucking more. I'm sorry, y'all. My ghosting is fucking terrible. Y'all know that. Everybody knows that. But fucking, damn. But yeah, bro, like, bro, that them niggas really sat there and lied for this nigga, bro, knowing this nigga was lying, but just to fuck with me because I was the troublemaker of the class. Cause y'all know, I was bad as hell as a little kid. But just for them to say that I said that shit when I know, now I'll admit, there was a few times where I lied to get out of situations, but that time I was dead ass telling the truth. So fucking, after that, got sent to the motherfucking principal's office, bro. So usually I get sent to the assistant principal, my nigga, shout out my nigga Dr. Sanks, man. Part where I love that nigga. My favorite principal of all time, Dr. Sanks. So usually when I used to get in trouble, they just send me to his office. He'd probably just throw me an ISS for the day, you know, some shit like that, right? But this time they sent me to the actual principal's office, like our actual principal. She was a lady. She was Miss Cassilli. So I go to Miss Cassilli's office and shit, right? And fucking, damn, somebody shit getting told. Yo, somebody shit is finna get told right now. That's crazy. But back my fault. Back to the damn story. But fucking So yeah, I get sick to Miss Cassilli's office, you know, shit like that. And so basically she was like, Marquell, we're gonna have to, so usually, you know, I got sent to ISS a few times during that year, but damn, this shit right here, she was like, mind you, like I said, because my teacher, she believed everybody else over me. So basically it was a 4-on-1, nigga. I was in that bitch trying to clutch a 4v1, nigga, like on some Fortnite shit, bro. Like, I was in that bitch trying to clutch a 4v1 on some ninja shit, bro. Like, so basically, I was in that bitch trying to clutch some on some ninja shit, on some myth shit, bro. But fucking so basically she suspended me. She was like, she was like, Marquell, we're gonna have to suspend you. I'm like, damn. I got suspended for 5 days, for a week. Yeah, I got suspended for a week. And so my mom, they was trying to call my mom. My mom's at work. Like, my mom at work, she don't answer the phone like that when she at work. So they called my fucking stepdad. And then my brother, you know, using my brother, like, my brother was in high school at the time when I was at elementary school. So he would always walk to the school to come get me. And so when my brother got there, they told him, then my stepdad came pick us. They told him. And so he was like, they told him what happened, everything. Mind you, I'm trying to explain to them what happened. Like, my stepdad, he was like, man, like, none of them are believing me. My brother not believing me. My stepdad not believing me. So then, so we get in the car, my fucking stepdad, he called my mom and he put her on speaker, right? Man, look, And so they told what happened. My mom was like, I'll deal with it when we get home. I already fucking knew what time. All right, at that point, I already knew what time it was, bro. I already knew I was finna get my ass beat, and she was gonna take some shit, right? So fast forward, shit, we get home, and fucking, I had some homework. I did my homework and shit. I'm just chilling, right, laying on my bed watching TV, right? So then, my mom get home, right? She said, I'm disappointed in you. Like, why did you say that? And I'm trying to explain to her, like, mom, like, I literally didn't say it. Like, he was capping. Like, because as a kid, my mom, she would never allow me to say the word lying, even to this day. And I'm a grown-ass man. She still don't let me say it. I still can't say lying around her. Like, and I'm a grown-ass fucking man. But, yeah, like, so, mind you, still, no one's believing me. It's damn near a 7-1 now, because you had the four people in my group, my teacher, my principals, and my mom, like, nobody's fucking believing me. Like, I'm literally public enemy number fucking one right now. Like, shit's crazy, right? Damn. This fucking gas is fucking hitting, my boy. Damn. Fucking, so then I go take a shower and shit, right? Eat, take a shower, all that shit, right? Now, mind you, I'm expecting her to beat my ass like she usually do, but she didn't. So, mind you, so shit, I go to get in the bed, you know what I'm saying? I go to get in the bed, right? She called me in the living room, and so we still talking about it. Then she said, I'ma show your ass. I said, oh shit. I thought I had got away scot-free. I thought she just gonna, cause she did when she got home, she took shit out my room. Like, she took my TV, took my, you know what I'm saying, like, took my toys and shit. Mind y'all, I was still a ass kid. I was in first grade, right? So she took all that shit, right? So I'm like, okay, she's just gonna take my, she not gonna beat my ass like I thought she was. But she called me in that living room, right when I was finna go to bed too. And we still talking about it. And she tell my brother to go get the belt. Man, I was begging and pleading her. She still not believe me. See, my mom, and I hate to keep breaking off on the story, but so basically, like, my mom, she was one of those moms that, like, she always believed, like, the teachers and shit over me a lot in school. Even in, like, middle school and high school, she was always like that. Like, she always believed the teachers and shit over me. Like, that's just how she was, bro. And fucking, in Renee's case, you know, she believed everything they say, even though, like I said, buddy was fucking lying, bro. And yeah, bro, she got that belt and beat the fuck out of me in that damn living room. I'll never forget. That was literally, like I said, I done got plenty of ass whoopers in my life, but that was the goddamn where she wore my ass out in that fucking living room with that damn belt. Like, I was fucking crying and shit, bro. And she said, go to bed. So I got my ass beat. I'm suspended, nigga. Go to bed, nigga. So that's pretty much how that ended. So then, like I said, now I'm suspended for, actually, I forgot to add, not only did I get suspended for a week, nigga, when I came back, I had 3 days of ISS, nigga. Like they I damn near went to damn jail at this point. Like, they gave my ass a mean ass punishment, my nigga. Like, I was like, damn, off of saying bitch, which I didn't even damn say the fucking word, but still, you know what I'm saying? Like, a week of suspension and 3 days of ISS, like, bro. So, and then to make it worse, my teacher gave me so much fucking work that I had to do during that time, nigga. By the time I got back to class, nigga, I was caught up, nigga, because I had to do all that other shit. Now, fucking, okay, so during the days that I was suspended was the fucking worst, nigga. My mom was on some bullshit, bro. Like, I was on fucking lock, nigga. I was on lockdown. I was on, like, bro, I had to get up. Like, she literally treated the day like it was a school day. Nigga, I had to get up and do work for hours. Then, after that, she had, like, she gave me a little free time. And then, like I said, I couldn't really do shit but just go sit in my room because I ain't had no fucking TV. She took my fucking TV. So, it's like, damn, bro. I'm just like, damn, bro. Like, and that was my fucking nigga. After that, nigga, I ain't get suspended no more after that. Wait, did I? Yeah, nah, I ain't get suspended no more. I did go to ISIS a few times in like second grade, third grade, but other than that, nigga, that was my last time get suspended, bro. That shit was crazy, but like, I really like, bro, that nigga really fucking lied on me, bro. Like, niggas really lied on me, bro, and that shit was crazy, man. Like, I to this day, I still can't believe that nigga lied on me, bro. And it's funny because the nigga that did it, I graduated with him. And me and him are cool now. Like, outside, like, now that we're grown, we're cool. And it's like, damn, like, this nigga really is the reason why I got my ass beat. Like, that shit crazy, but, like, and when I think about it, bro, it's just like, damn, like, my worst ass whooping came because of a lie, because somebody lied, bro. Now, if I could take back what I said, I would. Because, you know, because like I said, the nigga was Mexican. I called him a Cheeto-eating punk. But he told her, I said, Cheeto-eating bitch. And then my teacher fucking believed him because I was a troublemaker during that time. So, yeah, like I said, during the days I was suspended, yeah, my nigga, I was on lockdown. Nigga, I couldn't do shit, nigga. So then I finally go back to school. Mind you, when I go back, nigga, I got 3 days of ISS, bro. So, yeah, it was either 3 or 4. Yeah, it was 3 days of ISS. 3 days of ISS. Now, nigga, mind you, I just had to do hella work during that week I was suspended, nigga. So, I get the ISS. She got more work. It's my shit we ain't even learned yet. She sent the ISS for me to do for them 3 days, nigga. And funny thing is, bro, so, mind you, I had 3 days of ISS. I finished the work in 2 days. So, my ISS teacher dead ass sent me back to class. Nigga, when I walked into class, nigga, my teacher got big eyed as hell. She was like, I said, I finished all my work. They let me go. Then, she called Dr. Sinks, the Sinks principal. And she was like, hey, Marquell finished all his work. Are you ready for him to come back to class? This nigga gonna say no. So, I had to go back to ISS for the third day, even though I hadn't finished all the fucking work. And I'm just like, what the fuck? Like, I'm like, bro, can I catch a break around this bitch? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck? So, yeah, bro, and it's just like, literally, I finished all the work and still couldn't come back to class till after the third day. So, after the 3 days of ISS, bro, so I came back to class. Everybody was laughing, like, oh, man, I said, quick, I submitted, bro. I'm like, you know what I'm saying? He let shit phase me, bro. Now, mind you. Oh, shit. So, after that, me and him didn't get into it no more that year after that. Really, I ain't even talked to that nigga. Because I'm like, bro, you really just lied as fuck. Like, you really just lied on me and fucking snitched. Like, on some bitch shit. Fuck. I just dropped the blunt, but I'm single. So, whoever the bitch is, keep her. Anyways, fucking. But yeah, so after that, like I said, I went back to class and just, nigga, kept doing young nigga shit, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Macking on these hoes, you know what I'm saying? Like I was doing in first grade. And, just living life, bro. And so, like I said, the rest of the year, I think after that, I didn't go to ISS no more that year. Because I was just like, bro, it's not even worth it no more. Like, I got in trouble a few times. I got sent to the principal's office a few times. But it was never enough to just, like, send me back to ISS for the rest of that year. And, like I said, after first grade, I got plenty of more ass whoopers after first grade. But I think my mom stopped beating my ass when I got in. Literally, like, right before I got to middle school, that's when she stopped beating my ass. Like, stop whooping me, bro. She started taking, like, by then, I started playing games. She should just take my game and shit. And then I had a phone, too. like when the iPhone 4 first came out, I got that shit. She just took my phone and shit. Like other than that, and then once I got in middle school, I really just stopped getting in trouble because it really just wasn't worth shit, bro. But yeah, bro, when I was a kid, bro, I was a fucking demon, boy. Like, I just used to, bro, that shit used to be crazy, bro. I used to just be in this bitch chilling, bro. Just fucking chilling, bro. On some chill shit, bro. And, so yeah, the rest of the year just went by. I love Miss Roberts, fucking, damn, I forgot her name. I love her to death, bro. Fucking, yeah, man. That was a crazy time, man. Like, my childhood was really crazy, bro. And yeah, like I said, me and him, I don't want to go say his name because we cool now. You know, that shit's in the past. But damn, he really fucked me up, bro. He really got my ass beat. Like, got my ass beat the fuck up. And I'm gonna add a little bonus in this for y'all too, because it kind of correlates with the story. A few weeks later, after, you know, that all that happened, I got a little revenge on him too. Actually, I got his ass twice in the same week. So like I said, I got his ass back twice in the same fucking week too. So the first time I got his ass, we was in recess. Now mind you, so when we was in recess, we used to play football during recess. And like the girls in our class used to be the cheerleaders, right? So I used to fucking, so mind y'all, when I was a kid, I was a lot skinnier than, you know, I'm a big nigga now, but now I was a lot skinnier back then, right? And I used to goddamn, so I used to always play running back. Cause I was skinny as hell and I was fast as hell too. So I used to always play running back at recess, right? And one day, fucking, I ran a little screen and I caught the ball, and I goddamn Derrick Henry stiffed armed his ass and scored a touchdown in front of all the bitches. he was fucking sick. I'm talking about, I hit a mean ass Najee Harris on his ass in front of all the bitches, bro. So that was my first level of revenge. My second level of revenge, that was the news. And when this second level of revenge, it was my first time ever stealing too. So mind you, like I said, he was a, you know, he was Mexican, so he used to eat a lot of Cheetos and Takis and shit. Like, so one day, goddamn, I had one in his book bag. And he had a bag, he had like a Ziploc bag full of Takis. And I took them shits, put them in my bag. Actually, no, I hit them bitches in my desk. And so he was, at recess, he was crying because he ain't had no snack. But guess who had them? Me. And I took them bitches home and devoured them. Hey, you talking about, nigga? I told you, when I was in revenge, I used to get my shit. I got my shit back in blood. Stiffed on his ass and robbed his ass in the same week. Nigga, I felt like King Von after doing that shit. You know what I'm saying? I feel like fucking King Von after doing that shit. But yeah, man. I'd like to thank y'all for watching this story time, man. For sitting here with me while I smoked that blunt, man. And to reminisce about my childhood, man. Like I said, man, my childhood was wild. And it's going to be stories even wilder than this one. This is just a taste. This story right here is just a taste of what's to come. For my fucking stories, bro. Like I said, man, we got the podcast coming soon, man. Coming soon. Past the Blunt podcast. Me and my nigga J Sam. We gonna have that for y'all, man. We gonna get this shit pumping for y'all. We gonna get this shit right for y'all, man. We gonna turn up, go crazy. And yeah, man, I like to thank y'all for watching this story time, man. I'm a bro. Y'all gonna learn, bro. I was a crazy ass fucking kid, bro. Yeah, man. Follow my Twitch, man. MacZillaYT coming soon. Follow my IG, Zilly Mac with 2 Z's, man. And shit, without further ado, man, I'm gonna hit that bit one last time for y'all. Fuck. fuck. I'ma light up Queen Elizabeth one more time for y'all. Yeah, this been done for. But thank y'all for watching, man. Subscribe to the channel. And I'll see y'all niggas later.
Fine, oh, you turn out fine. But you gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey. You gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey.